produce yet another Milk First Child makeup look. I would insert the picture here so that you can see the reference chart I used for today's video. I hope you will enjoy watching this tutorial, so I'll let you ready to go. Okay, so for once I did my base makeup on camera. So I'm still using basically all the same products as usual. I put all the links down below anyway, but I'm using the same concealer in the shade the 0.5, and then I'm using my usual foundation. It's a Pu, it's a Korean brand. I'm using a lot of Korean products because I have very dry skin, as I already mentioned in another of my videos. And since their products are really hydrating, I really love using that. And for the highlights and stuff, I'm using my NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop concealer. I don't remember the shade, to be honest with you, so I just try to look on the website and to again put everything down below. But I'm just basically doing my base makeup. I basically do the same thing every day. I rarely change my base makeup just because I love the way my routine looks, so that's basically it. I'm just adding a lot of different products to my face. So I'll let you watch that and then I'll come back for the eye makeup tutorial. Okay, so now it's time to start with the eyes. So I'm taking my usual Beauty Bay eyeshadow palette, and you can basically do any color scheme you want, but I wanted to follow the first face chart 100%, so I went with pink today. I'm starting with a light pink under my eyebrow and on the bottom lash line, and then I'm using two different darker pink shades to add that dimension to the eye makeup, and I'm going back and forth the lighter and darker shades just to make it even and to blend everything out, just to make the look to make the look look pretty, let's say that. And I will also add a little shimmery pink under the eyebrow just to again add a bit of dimension. Now moving on to my favorite part. If you're a regular watcher of either my YouTube channel or TikTok, you know that I'm very fond of Strass, and this is exactly for that reason that I wanted to recreate this face chart today. I didn't exactly follow the same placement of the face chart, and you can do that as well. You can just put the Strass whenever you want. it's just for you to, well, enjoy the look, so you don't have to exactly follow what you're seeing. You can just adapt the look to your own preferences. So that's what I did today. And as per usual, my strass come from the British website called Evil Cosmetics. So that's basically it. Then I'm adding some black eyeliner or eyeliner in my lash line, and in the bottom lash line I add a bit of white eyeliner. I never know how to call these because it's not eyeliner, but yeah. And I'm doing that just to make it look less weird when I put my fake eyelashes on, since I don't have a transparent lash band. I use eyelashes that have a black band, so just to make it less weird, I'm just putting some black eyeliner in the upper lash line. And once I'll be done with gluing my lashes down, I will add some black lipstick, and it comes from Manier Miret's brand. It's Lunar Beauty one. So that's basically it for today's look. That you enjoy watching this video. Bye!